Are you looking to boost your brain power, whether it's you want to do better on your exams or you want to be able to focus better at work, or simply because you want to stay as sharp as possible? You've probably heard of neurofeedback brain training and nootropics as two options, but which one is the ultimate cognitive enhancer? And so we're going to break that down today. So first off, let's define what we're talking about. So neurofeedback is brain training. It's a method that uses EEG technology, so taking the brain waves, to provide feedback to your brain in real time. And you can think about it as a workout for the brain. Nootropics, on the other hand, are substances, whether natural or synthetic, that claim to enhance your brain function and focus. These include things like caffeine and supplements like l-theanine, which is also found in tea, and more complex compounds like racetams. So the question is, how do they work? They're very different. Neurofeedback works by training the brain to regulate itself better. It uses your brain's natural neuroplasticity, which is the ability to reorganize itself to improve its ability to focus, reduce stress, and improve memory. Nootropics, on the other hand, are affecting your neurotransmitter activity, including blood flow to the brain and decreasing oxidative stress. So, what are the benefits and what are the drawbacks? Both have pros and cons. Neurofeedback offers long-term results. You're training your brain to function better on its own, to focus without external crutches. However, it takes time and commitment to see the full effects. In the same way, if you go to the gym once, you're not going to expect huge results, really, if you want to improve your strength and your physical health. So nootropics, on the other hand, are like a quick boost. If you need sharper focus for a big meeting, or you know you have to study really hard, you know, you might want to pop a pill or take some extra caffeine. The thing is that there are side effects with prolonged use, and so something to think about. So next question is, what's the best thing for me? So if you're looking for a holistic approach that enhances your brain's natural functioning and provides lasting benefits, then neurofeedback might be the right answer. But if you need a short-term boost and you're okay with doing some homework on what the right substances for you, the nootropics might be a good thing for you. But you just want to make sure that you consult a professional before diving into that option. And then the next option, of course, is do both. So neurofeedback plays the role of long-term brain training so that your focus and your ability to use that memory to de-stress, right, is there for you. And then when you need that extra boost or you're concerned about studying, particularly in the beginning when you're doing your neurofeedback and you haven't done that many sessions, you do your nootropic to help yourself to focus better in that one moment. So please subscribe if you're interested in more videos about brain training and neurofeedback, and leave a comment or a question for us.